Dave Zanetti, surprised at seeing him step up, take the first tap to get us underway. Perfect conditions, as Dexter may mention, the surface is absolute carpet out there. We can't play a hard, fast track for the teams this afternoon. Huda is imminent. And here we go. State of Origin Series for 2022 is underway. And it is Queensland. We'll be looking to strike early. Cody Green comes in, gets into the 7 metre zone, decides to kick out, switches in Shaun Francis. They put the ball back through the hands. Cody Green again. Now linking up with David Sen. Zanetti comes in, fires a left to right. Nice slide defence here from New South Wales. Good start for them. Francis now loops a huge right to left. Twin Living, that man we made mention. They will not let that one get away. Threw it right on the try line edge. You could see it float forward, caught in the in-goal area there from Tommy Q.
Good start from both teams. Good aggressive attack from Queensland, but New South Wales defence opting to roll back to the try line, inviting Queensland into the seven. Unfortunately, not able to get a strike done, but it's good to see Francis playing in the 30s, coming out of half. And I tell you what a touch it was by the nine. James shoot out on the New South Wales right-hand touchline as we see Wingard now out of half.
Oh, off the fingertips there of Cody Green as well. Back into their set. Gives them another full set of six. A good attacking position here, the Blues.
I just mentioned him. Number 11, Caden Wing. And if he can get one-on-one with a defensive player, there's not many that are going to be able to go with him. The amount of footwork he possesses is just incredible. So we can see Caden one-on-one in a bit of open space. Going to be beautiful to watch.
Burke plays it. Moylan in half. Oh, intercepted here. Sean Francis has picked it off. Has he got the legs to go the full distance? He looks at the little bit tight as the cover defence comes across. Sean Francis takes a big breath in. He might head over towards the interchange box. Hasn't quite got the glory days. The old Sean Francis, would have seen him streak away.
Tell you what, full of confidence, Francis taking it upon himself to come out of half, then pluck it out of the air and put his team in a great field position.
Nice late ball at the line, but good defence as well. James Coote, another one of the experienced players for the New South Wales team. Still looking calm. Defence, Rasmussen now outside the seven. Go away, come back infield. Looping ball over the top, shoot comes across and makes the touch, forces the mistake. They regain possession. Good recovery after a nervous bit there. As Storm Francis streak down the field.
So New South Wales will look to get some fresh legs onto the field as they elect to go to the sub box straight away. Possibly a forward pass from New South Wales, but told to play on. They've got some good structure, New South Wales, coming out of their half as per usual. So let's see if they can implement something in attack here.
Nice kick out. Good meters come into the fifth there on the back foot here. Buckley, beautiful left to right. Threw it early. Tough one to take there from Daniel Barton.
Tell you what, if Barton was standing a few metres to the right, I'd say he's walking over if he catches that ball. But all in all, good defence by Queensland.
Over towards the sideline, the Queenslanders. Gives them fresh players onto the field. Green over the halfway line as Adams rolls forward, links up. Good metres with David Sen. Sen now on last touch. Hit over Luda. A bit of space out here. Green holds it. Oh, links up. Finds a man in the blue jersey. Thomas, New South Wales, who kicked the intercept off, but Queensland there to make the touch. Ooh, a little bit of a mistake in the play of the ball. Seemed that it's come off a Queensland foot. Appearance in the ruck. New South Wales, another set of six. Have to roll it forward. Roberts now steady to ship. Dave Maher, one to watch for the Blues. Instrumental in the 30s. Series win last year. Gives the early ball this time. Has the touch been made? They're going to point to the spot, and we've got our opening try of the State of Origin series. And David Sen there, he's pulling a little bit flat-footed on the line.
We mentioned before, Caden Wingard, give him an inch and he'll take a mile. Great first try there by New South Wales, running the little sweeper play. Wingard coming from right to left, using his body well, actually. The Queensland defensive player was close to making the touch, but he actually kicked his body out towards the sideline and sliding over. Great play by Wingard as Queensland now making it look too easy through Dave Zanetti. You mentioned him. What an absolute competitor he is. He's one of those players you love to play with but hate to play against. The passion that he shows, just incredible. There was one key moment, I remember, in the 2019 World Cup in Malaysia. He scored a try and he was pointing to the crowd, asking them to get up, get off their feet. So it just shows what an absolute competitor he is, Dave Zanetti.
Yeah, opening points for Queensland, good response. New South Wales come up with points. Zanetti getting on the outside of Daniel Barton there, the two number fours. Very familiar with each other. So we see Buckley now try to roll through. Sean Francis makes the touch.
That's that Penrith combination. They love their inside-outside trick plays. Buckley and Moylan.
It's those two men combining in the midfield at the moment. Here they go again. Moylan holds it up and Shawnee Francis again. Almost falling in the bread basket, but he probably looked up and saw how far he was going to go. And he, a bit of a struggle last time around. And it was there for him to take. Moylan again. Steps in field. And Francis comes up out of the line. Touch is made. It did spill out of the hands. The referee has indicated that the touch was made. Or any loss of control of the football. Come out now to the left-hand edge. To attack the short side. Early ball from Buckley stepping in off the left foot. And then touch made again. Queensland answering the call defensively so far in this set. Up in the midfield with Mitch Burke. He plays it. Last, it's now Moylan. Couldn't find a target on the left-hand side.
Wasted opportunity there for New South Wales. They had some strike players on in the middle. For Queensland, defending well. See if they can head up the other end.
Yeah, interesting there. Sean Francis on touch one.
No touch call.
Yeah.
So that means the player has played the ball without actually being touched, which constitutes a changeover. So New South Wales, again, gifted good field position.
Joe Nung plays it on touch one. On the opportunity, you may mention, Lizzie again, the Blues on the attack. Mark is on the outside. Francis, he's having to do a lot of defensive work.
He's very long, Francis. Takes a lot to get around his outside.
As Mark, sweet, rip, beautiful ball on the outside. No, referee says, going forward. Half a chance there for New South Wales.
After nearly crossing the line, scored 6 tries last year. Four in the first game, where the actual end result was 13 tries to 8 in favour of New South Wales. Only one apiece, 7 minutes played here at CEX Stadium. So plenty of tries surely left out there, Scott, that we're going to see in the future.
Yeah, absolutely. Both teams still feeling each other out at the moment, but it's Queensland coming up with another. It was actually a penalty this time coming around. On-field referee deeming attacking player was hooking one of the New South Wales players to get an advantage in the ruck. Again, another full set to New South Wales. And they take advantage, loose pass, left to right, sailing across the face. So just not quite taking the opportunities that they've had down that end of the field just yet.
No, well, one of the most experienced players in the game, Daniel Barton, sweeping around left to right and took one step forward and threw it straight to the wing, and his brother, Tim Barton, just watched it go past his face. So there might be a little bit of a brotherly banter out there as well as brotherly love, but Daniel Barton won't be happy with that.
Brady Green just having it come back, overrunning the mark, and tries to fire one out. Adams now switching in Quinn Liven.
Just seems like the two teams are still trying to figure out their flow, how to actually get themselves into the game. We've seen a few passes. Oh, I thought there was a ball down there, but they just need to get some structure back into the drive, back into their attacking moves or sets or situations. Queensland sort of look to drive in nice and hard for a dummy half runner, where New South Wales are actually using sweepers to try and spread the defence. So two different styles of play here from New South Wales and Queensland. Both one apiece, so both obviously working effectively, but just still don't seem to be at the level that they want to be.
A good defensive set for the Maroons on the previous play. Last touch now. Shibasaki gets into the in-goal area. No support. At least finish their set off down the right end of the field. It'll be interesting to see how New South Wales come out of their end here. They've been really happy putting the ball through the hand, often cutting players out. They just put it through nicely now as Moylan picks up good metres on touch one. Bit of space out here on the left-hand side. Big diving effort there from Trevor Morant. On-field's come back for a forward pass. They're still happy to throw the footy around, though, New South Wales. We saw early in the touch count. Touch two there. Still the space. Tommy Dafter on his left-hand edge. Then weak threat now. In the number seven, ball in hand. This is off. Queensland just looking to get their attacking shape sorted. Zanetti throws the ball in one hand. Numbers out here. Looping ball over the top and a desperate touch. But no, the referee says that the ball was down first. And Queensland get their second. And it just took a little lollipop pass over the top from Dave Zanetti.
He's so good around the line, Dave Zanetti. You could see him trying to suck the New South Wales defence out to the 7 metre line. If they make it on the 7, they then have to get to the try line. And he just holds it up so well. Gets Scott Buckley up and out of the line. And a little dinky lollipop, as you mentioned, over the top. One of the hardest balls to defend against is that little lollipop. Because all you're expecting is a bullet to come past your face or to be sent to the winger, not over your head. Very difficult ball to defend and a very difficult ball to actually throw. The credit, Dave Zanetti with the try assist.
Try scored by Josh Smart. Queensland, New South Wales, though, skipping back on the right foot. They're going to take it away from them, though. Lee Lavery, indicating there was a little bit of contact between players. The Queensland player might have been taken off the ball. A big pull. Sees Queensland get possession back. Chance gone begging there for New South Wales. Sobeluda and David Sten. Zanetti, again, still on the field. Numbers trying to squeeze it through and just getting a hand onto the ball. Daniel Barton, not much doing there for Queensland. Ideally, probably wanted to just let that one hit the carpet.
Yeah, it was a good bit of lead-in play by Queensland, actually using their foot speed to isolate a defender. And New South Wales were on the back foot in that instance. And it was good to see Zanetti wrapping around, creating the option. We see a sweeper play, but electing to go short side through Zanetti. So they're testing the waters, Queensland, but New South Wales, good defence.
Eight on the seven. Overloader comes out, sent again, deflection. There's a fight for the ball. They will get a penalty, though. Queensland, New South Wales players not moving forward off the line.
And the player's going to afford to throw the ball long. Not much wind. And the ground, as you mentioned, is very dry, very, very quick, you might say. So there could be, throughout the afternoon, some beautiful long balls on display.
Kibisaki dives in at the line. Touches made. On two. Midfield now. Weak threat plays it outside the seven. They go down the short side. Ooh, just losing his footing. Comes back midfield. Zanetti. Yeah, flat ball there. Worth a groan for sure. Ooh. Just overrun the assignment there. Looked like the ball just stuck in Dave's hands a little bit.
It's actually credit to New South Wales link defence there. Caden Wingard in the 11 on the left-hand side. He was actually pressing up while Queensland were trying to come into the line, which actually squeezes that open side, makes it a bit shorter for the ball player to come out and have as much space. So Caden doing his job, helping his middle, even though the middle makes the touch, it really shortens that open side, which cuts down all of the attack for Queensland. So New South Wales showing good defence yet again.
Penalty as well. Queensland player getting into the ruck. A couple of sloppy penalties from both teams. Moylan, left foot, comes out to the right-hand side. They come back midfield now. Mark gets into half. Hits it once. Loops over the top to Buckley. And no touch there. And New South Wales will lock us back up. And they get their second try on the board. And what a beautiful setup that was indeed from the men in blue.
Yeah, we watched Zanetti do it moments ago with a little lollipop over the top. This one probably had a bit more spice to it. But rather than release it at body height, you can actually see the player release the ball above his head, which actually creates a nice dip over the link defender. Again, such a difficult ball to throw. But New South Wales with the execution, tying it up. 14 minutes played. It's 2-2 here in the men's 30s division.
Josh Smart heading across field. Try scorer for Queensland. There was space out there as well. Switched in. Tommy Quinn Livin took a little bit of a juggle. Now feeding it through the line is the man in number one, Lawrence Oberluda. My apologies. It's been calling Christian Kongu incorrectly. He's in number five. Two men from up north. Penalty here to New South Wales. Moylan gets us back underway. Again, both teams really testing where the referees are at in the ruck. Getting bodies in position to try and slow it up. Francis makes the touch again. Open space and a real lack of communication there between the Queenslanders. There's hands on heads and a couple of the middle defenders. You can see Lawrence Oberluder there shaking his head. Try scored from New South Wales. Puts them up by one.
Well, it is Tim Boland. His first time in the men's 30s. New South Wales, and it's the Parramatta combination. Wing it out of half. Great drive by Joe Noong. It looked like he just walked over. All the defensive line peeled away, and Tim Boland just strolled through to put New South Wales up 3-2.
Sweep around, trying to dive in underneath it. Is that man Christian Kongu?
That's good defense again by New South Wales, making sure they're stepping up off the line before making the touch.
Adams tips it across. Kongu, you don't want to give him in too much space. He's got lightning feet.
That's dangerous. I could feel my knees start to buckle from here, Scott, watching some of these players come off their left, come off their right. The ankles might begin to swell at the end of the commentary by just watching the absolute skill of some of these players, and good defense early on by Queensland here.
Changes come on now. Buckley does come onto the field. Mark Roberts comes back into the midfield. Robert in the half. Dummies just opening. Buckley still manages to get away from one. They will come back in the midfield. Oh, an instruction call it was. So New South Wales players running around behind their own players and gaining advantage. Almost created a little something. Well, we can see how the reason why they might have created that number space is Rasmussen holds onto the ball. Heads back to the mark.
Oh, a little cheeky.
Searching for over the mark penalties. Weeks are it. Oh, and over that. Fingertips there of Tommy Q.
There he is, Quinn Livin. As we mentioned, one of the highest try scorers to ever represent at State of Origin level. Definitely knows his way across the try line. Do you reckon the player that scores so often gets frustrated when they literally haven't scored in the first 17 minutes of a game?
It would just feel unnatural for him, you know?
Like, what am I doing out here?
Exactly. Feed me some meat pies, boys. So it's not going to be too long until you see him cross over. And we'll see if it unfolds here in the first game of the series. But on the flip side, as we see him and talk about him being a try scorer, it's such an important facet of the wing play now is their defence. And Tommy coming in there and making sure that one got shut down.
There was Moylan out of half. I thought he could have hit short. It seemed like the middle started to spread, but Tim Boland coming from the field looks like he's copped a little bit of a knock. Hopefully it's just a bit of a stinger. Crossing the line, New South Wales, it was Tim Boland. He seems to be walking around all right on the sideline, but New South Wales, again, gifted good field position by another Queensland error.
They're playing the ball without being touched. It's a call from the on-field referee, Matty Laver, and it just seems like neither team, although New South Wales have got the slight advantage at the moment, so we'll see this play out. Oh, lightning feet. Hayden Wynyard, you've highlighted him.
Tell you what, Wynyard goes very close on that occasion. Steps off his right, steps off his left, and gets at the line. Here he goes again.
Moylan pumps again. Contact made. And they lose control of the football there. Tim Button out here on the left-hand side.
It's a good read by Tom Quinn Livin on that occasion. One thing that's underestimated at this level is the ball speed. The speed that the ball travels at. People don't understand. It's so fast. You can actually hear it zip through the air. So to actually peel out like Tom did there on that occasion, it shows how good he actually is.
And no touch has been made. David Senn jinking his way to the line, but that was a really impressive set from Queensland. Probably the first set where they've come out of their end that they've actually shown some good intent and good drive coming out of their end, and they put the icing on the back of that set. They'd be happy with that.
It's a beautiful set by Queensland. David Senn crossing for his first try of the campaign. Scored three last year. One in the second, then two in the third game. He's an experienced campaigner, isn't he, Dave Senn?
Speaking of experienced campaigners, Scotty Butley ripping a right into the corner of the Queensland defence. Was there to answer the call. And as predicted, we thought it would be a tight tussle between these two teams to open up the State of Origin series, and nothing can separate them at the moment. Three tries apiece.
I've said it before, Scott, it always makes me a bit nervous. That team that scores just before half-time, they're the one that goes into the second half with all the momentum. Sometimes if you get scored against just before half-time, your head drops, the emotions start to pick up, but it's going to be interesting coming back in the second, three apiece.
Yeah, nothing to be separating these two teams going into the half-time break. Make a quick break ourselves. We'll be back with all the second half action of Game 1 of the Men's 30s in just a few moments' time.
Grassroots the great, whether you're playing the local under 18 or the Queensland State of Origin team, Inferno has the perfect kit for you. Inferno for every player. Have you got your recovery routine sorted? Try Physio Cramp. Physio Cramp can help improve muscle recovery time, relieve symptoms of muscle injury, and even help enhance muscle performance. It's one of the top three products in its category and is popular with everyday athletes all over Australia. That's Physio Cramp. Players and referees, 2 minutes, 2 minutes, players and referees. One minute, players and referees. 1 minute, please take the field.
Both teams have made their way back out for the second half. See Scotty Buckley on screen there, who will get us back underway. Locked up at 3 tries apiece. Milty, really entertaining first half. But it just seemed like both teams just probably had some early game jitters, which are fine in game one of the State of Origin series. Whoever can clean those type of errors up will probably go a long way to claim the first game here this afternoon.
Yeah, both teams just probing one another. They're trying to find out when the strength fit in with the opposition's weakness. But yeah, Buckley, good first half, scored a try himself. See if New South Wales can get a few more on the board with a little big
Oh, no. Taken away. James Stewart looked at the referee and says, sir, please.
See, on that occasion, I just think they should give the try. Even if it's forward.
Your skill.
It's, even if it's forward, it still looked perfect, great for the highlight reels. Give the try. Just give it.
Give them half a point at least.
Something.
They'd be up 3.5 points to 2 at the moment. Oh, 3.5 to 3. At Queensland. We saw that a little bit in the first half, just those mistakes coming out of their end of the field as they were heading over towards the substitution box. Would have been probably something they would have spoken about at the halftime break.
Exactly, and New South Wales coaching staff would have alluded to the sort of lull, I guess. Call it a lull, I don't know if it's the right word, but New South Wales just finding their feet, so they need to start fast, and I'm sure that would have been communicated to them at halftime as Wingard comes around.
They'll come back.
If he catches that, is that a try? Because it came off Quinn Liven. Oh, they've given actually. They've given a forward pass.
Yeah, that's the only thing that could really have taken it away. Forward out of the hands. Call from the on-field referees. We see a penalty go to another Queensland. One. Who really still testing the boundary in the ruck. It'll be interesting to see how long the referees are happy to let this go. Because they definitely had the whistle in the mouth quite a few times in the first half. Queensland now was smart. Skips away. Switch in. Shibasaki now plays it. Pongu in the half. He'll pick it up. Comes off the left foot. Holds it. Goes short to Ryan Shibasaki. Touch made there by Dave Maher.
Great touch by Dave Maher. But Shibasaki with the footwork, the dancing footwork, the little short pump, long pump, then hit short again. Great skill.
Play on the call here. Queensland player jumping over the top of the ball. He's deemed not to get himself in a position where he impeded the ruck. Tripping Pongu again. New South Wales flat coming into back into their count.
Will be Barden out of half. 10 throw left to right. Tell you what, lucky they called that ball down because Joe Nung was not catching that ball. He actually dropped it over the line. So lucky escape there for Queensland on both occasions, really. Daniel Barton, the number 4 for New South Wales, very experienced campaigner, has represented New South Wales and Australia, multiple Trans-Tasman caps plus has represented Australia at World Cups, actually a world champion in both men's and mixed. One of the greatest defenders to ever play the game, Daniel Barton, and his brother sitting out on the wing on the left-hand touchline, Tim Barton. Very good AFL player. Actually stands at about 6'7". Very long levers, hard to throw over him. So best for Queensland to sort of keep it low to the ground.
Well, he's defending on New South Wales' left-hand side, Queensland's right-hand side. You might feel they'll come away from that side of the field. They don't know. They go down that side. Coming off the fingertips there of Ken Adams, getting a rocket from Zanetti, straight from half. Go through the hands. Is that man Daniel Barton? Boylan comes back onto the field. Bar as well. Links up. Boylan in the half. Last touch here for New South Wales. Oh, almost taken there from Dave Zanetti. He had a couple of grabs at it. Just couldn't quite reel it in. Full set of 6 here to the Blues. Still locked at 3 tries apiece. Now, Scott Buckley takes his time on touch one. Go away from Moylan. They feed it early and having to come in and put hands on the ball there. James Sharp closing that one down.
Dave Maher got hit late too off the ball. And I think that's exactly what the referee's alluding to. He copped a bit of a shoulder charge by Dave Zanetti out there in the right-hand link. But it's with Scott Buckley.
Boylan feeds it again. Maher, left foot, opens up through the middle. Beautiful play from the Blues. And we've seen the combination of Buckley, Moylan and Maher, and they put it on there to get New South Wales' four.
Great ball movement for New South Wales. Good strike dump by Buckley. Moylan out of half. Big left foot step. Dave Maher puts Moylan through another gap.
Moylan feeds it again. Maher, left foot, opens up through the middle.
Moylan's
beautiful
another
play from the blue.
Experienced campaigner who has represented Australia multiple times, multiple levels. The brother of Matt Moylan, 5'8 for the Sharks, who actually makes his comeback from injury tonight. The Sharks take on Manly.
You see the dancing feet again. Christian Kongu picks up the penalty for the Queenslanders. South Wales. Early ball there to Francis. They played out the back, but Lawrence Overluder, he wasn't ready for it. And that combination there, Christian Kongu, Overluder and Francis, all boys from up north, they might have a chat to Lawrence. We've run this play 1,000 times before, no doubt. Just that half whisker away early in the touch count.
It's such a clever play by Queensland. New South Wales not expecting it, and Francis just popping out the back. But you're right, Overluder wasn't ready, sitting back deep in the link. He would have been straight through that hole if he was pressing through. Possibly a missed opportunity there by Queensland to level things back to four apiece.
Tony Francis now. Possibly a little bit of footwork as well. Kongu, much of the same. Big touch made there from Mitch Burke.
Say he just got his fingernail to him. Some pretty fantastic feet there on display by Queensland.
And just flow onto the park now for New South Wales as Mark Roberts plays it. Switch and run back out to Bolin. On last now, Buckley feeds it, flicks out the back. That connects. They're rolling over for more points.
It's a clever play by New South Wales. What actually happened on about touch three, they look like they're going to come back to the right edge. And when they look to come back to the right edge, the right edge defensively of Queensland start to retreat because they think the ball's going to go to the other side of the field. So what they're trying to do is get early pre-touch. But they actually came back to that side where all the defence were rolling. So New South Wales gained another 10, 15 metres. Unfortunately, couldn't execute at the end. But it's such a clever setup, and Queensland really need to start to pick things up here in the second half.
Well, they need to pick things up right here in this set. They're a little bit all over the place as players running into each other. Looking a little bit clunky. And as a result, New South Wales on touch one here will play it in Queensland's end of the field. Rolls forward. Josh Phillips now directing traffic. Holds it. Plays it. Scoop up. Back midfield. Oh, dropped over the line. A big chance there.
Joe Nung. He dropped one earlier, but they brought it back for a little bobble in the ruck. And again, Joe just putting it down over the line. Phil Daniel Barton had a few words to him. You just got to keep your head up in those situations. I know it's a chance gone begging, but just do your job and make it up for your team. But Queensland now with a good roll on.
David Sen comes back midfield. Ken Adams picks the ball up in one hand, holds it in the left, nothing doing. Turn the ball back over to the Blues. Rolls forward on touch one. Phillip forward on two. Maher again, two touches in the first three. It's over towards the sideline. To Molan, switches. Moylan picks up from half, hold, look, base out here on the left-hand side for New South Wales. Do they capitalise? Referees are going to point to the spot. They capitalise beautifully and get the fifth on the board. Puts them up by two.
Great roll on again by New South Wales. Just moving the ball so efficiently, so effectively. It just creates a nice flow, nice, easy go forward. And it doesn't help when Queensland are rolling backwards for themselves because all Moylan did was take the ball deep into the line, wait wait, and saw the winger was too far in, just used the ball speed to get it out to James Shute and crosses the line to put New South Wales up by 2.
We'll just quickly mention having a few technical issues with our replays at the moment. Team's working on getting that sorted as soon as possible. We'll bring you all the top prize for our matches coming up later on this afternoon. Early ball flying through the air. And Christian Kongu is really starting to inject himself into the game.
We'll run by Queensland. A little sweeper with a pass back on the inside, trying to go against the grain of New South Wales defence, but
oh, good sly defence.
That is great defence by New South Wales. Ben Moylan.
Looked like they were gone, didn't it? As they get back on the attack. This time, Quinn Living tried to sleep in. No. Big touch. And New South Wales are really up and about in the box. This is a huge defensive set for them. Two really big stops to the men in blue. Can they continue to hold out? Francis shows it. Tries to slip in between the middle. They say, nope. Not today. That's a huge set there from New South Wales.
Great scramble defence by New South Wales. We saw Moylan come across the touchline. He's playing in the middle and made the touch on the wing. It was actually Simbolan that shut short. As we see Dave Maher get a bit of space here, but it was Simbolan that shut short. A bit of contact on Maher.
Yeah, they're on the back foot again here. Queensland looping ball over the top. And they just weren't in it at all at any stage in that set. New South Wales just rolling right through the Queenslanders. Beautiful left to right there. Scott Buckley put it on. We have a look at the replay now coming up.
There you go. Lovely to have that back in action. Scott Buckley, there's a great YouTube video of him, the most athletic player to ever play the game, apparently. That's the title of the video, not my video.
Did he put it up himself? Who's the content creator on that one?
Scott Buckley. Uploaded by Scott Buckley.
Hang on, isn't it? What an amazing player he's been. Named one of the players of the in the Golden Jubilee team. Still absolutely turning it on. He could be playing men's open later on this evening. He's still playing that good. This time, Cody Green opens up. Kenny Adams slams it down. They needed that one. Queensland, boy, oh boy.
Good play by Cody Green. Taking it on the inside and coming off his right foot. Just catching Buckley coming across, turning his shoulders. And with the evasiveness and speed of Cody Green's footwork, he just come off his right foot, turn the player inside out. And it's an easy hit back by Queensland.
The try scored there by Ken Adams. That margin back down to 2-4 on the scoreboard. The looping pass doesn't connect on this occasion. Out in front of the feet there of Daniel Barton. There's still plenty of time on the clock here for Queensland. They're able to work themselves back into the match. Back-to-back tries will definitely be the focus for them. Oh, loose pass back on the midfield. Christian Kongu now. Cody Green. Oh, flicking it off the chest there of Ryan Shibasaki. Lucky to get away with the over the mark. Green. That's possible. It's fallen into the hands there of Dave Maher. I don't think anyone's going to come close. Our referees will be the ones that will take it back. This is going to be an interesting call. I think they've indicated that there have been a touch made simultaneously. Dave Maher doesn't seem too disappointed with the call. I think it's Christian Kongu. Sure, Dave Maher and Christian just have to give it a little bit of a high five.
Must have just nicked him on the way through. It'll touch 6 again. But it is 6-4. 13 minutes played here in the second half as Tim Barton comes in from the left-hand touchline looking to inject himself. Short pen by Queensland there, I'd say.
Last touch now for New South Wales. Wynyard, yips, links up with Simbolan. Oh, hits Cody Green right on the chest.
Good pass, it's the wrong player.
Wrong coloured jersey. Experience though, if we see the ball spill out, it could only be 2 things, a turnover or a penalty.
Yeah, Moylan striking the ball on that occasion. You'd start to think that maybe a little bit of gamesmanship starts to creep its way in from New South Wales, trying to take a little bit of time off the clock.
Smart sweeps around. I'm off his right foot, gets away from one, and then off the fingertips. How many times throughout the match have we seen that where it looks like one of the two teams has created those numbers, but they're just getting their hands in there. Stop the play. Queensland full set of six. Feel like they need to score in this set. Oh, again, they try to go that little sneaky play on touch one. Definitely aware of it. Sean Francis knew it was coming, but it just came off his fingertip. Francis does come up and make the first touch. A bit flat-footed here in South Wales and Queensland. They smell blood in the water and come up and put some pretty good defensive pressure on in the first few touches of the set. The contact again. It's getting messy. It's going to be a penalty.
Oh, wow. That's fifth and last. Queensland had New South Wales absolutely cooked in their own 20-metre line and just gifted them a lifesaver.
They really hurt, don't they? That's the one over in the coaching box for Queensland where they really would have felt like they were starting to get the momentum back. And they were in that set as well. Just a lazy penalty back in the set, as you said, Milsey, that hurt.
Well, New South Wales have to be smart here. They can use up 2 minutes of the clock just by throwing the ball around in the middle. They could also create an opportunity, and it is Buckley out of half.
The referees are going to give the penalty, though. It only kind of indicate maybe that they weren't happy with the pass from Buckley. If it's gone forward, I'm not too sure. Otherwise, potentially should have been play on.
That's where the rule gets a bit murky, because that's a try to New South Wales, sending them up by three. The on-field referees called an offside play. You know, the refs call, Scott. We're probably the best referees standing up here, but they're on field. They're watching it. Best seat in the house.
Yeah, exactly. We're only five levels above where I ever got in the refereeing ranks, so we're definitely going to go with their calls for sure. Like I said, New South Wales still not a bad position to be in. They're definitely winding the clock down. Tony Francis just cannot take a prick. Giving penalties away, that's back-to-back for him. Like he lost his footing. Connection, though, with the ball in the ruck. Still in the ruck.
As you mentioned before, New South Wales just eating time up. The likes of Buckley and Barton, just the experience they have. They'll use their gamesmanship. They'll know exactly what to do to try and drain the clock down as much as possible. They'll still be looking for a try, don't get me wrong. Just how long it takes to get the try may come into it.
Open side they come. Now with Barton. Pulls out. Phillips takes the touch. Barton again. Just cruisy as you like. Johnny Buckley does the same. Holds the ball up. Queensland will have to come up and make the touch. They do now. Buckley numbers out here on the left-hand side going short of the line this time off the fingertips of Sean Francis.
You start to think now that Queensland need a penalty or an error from New South Wales, go up the other end and score a touchdown, because time is ticking away for them. 2 minutes to play. New South Wales 6-4 here in the first game of the State of Origin series under 30's division.
Buckley steps back midfield, Noon feeds it. Again, a little deflection off Francis. Come back in field again. Just winding those seconds down the clock.
Well, they know what they're doing, Scott. They know exactly what they're doing, how to drain the clock. And Queensland letting them do just that, not getting up in their face, not showing any urgency. If I was Queensland, I'd be hitting the referee and trying to push up as fast as possible, making New South Wales actually make a play at it.
Yeah, the touch made there on Josh Phillips. Queensland finally get the ball back.
Need to score in this set. Can they go the length, Queensland?
Put it through the hands nicely. On the front foot as the changes come onto the field. Cody Green gets across the halfway line. Good meters into the line here from Cody Green. Pongu links up. And Adams, New South Wales now, just holding their defensive line. Oh, a little flicky, streaky little flicky out the back. It would have been a hut to pick up on. You had to have your eyes on it. Green now. Oh, that might have gone forward. Yes, it definitely has.
I wish I had that type of skill, just to be able to flick the ball out the back, no look, creating an actual try scoring opportunity.
Well, it almost looked like he just held it out in the back, and then I think it might have been Christian just came and just took it from him.
Little NFL trick play.
They definitely haven't died wondering, the Queenslanders. Plenty of little trick plays haven't come off for them. Dave Maher, again, impressive in the opening game. Ball back to Queensland. Davidson feeds it from Haar. Huda goes in the background, and the touch has been made from Liam Simbolan, and New South Wales have taken game one here in the men's 30s division. Pretty impressive game between both teams, but New South Wales at the times where it was critical, they made Queensland pay.
You've got to put it down to the experience of the likes of Moylan and Buckley really taking it on themselves to put their team out in front. You saw Buckley nearly involved in every single try. Those little partnership combinations between Buckley and Moylan, and then you've got the Paraboys through Simbolan, Wynyard, Noong, Barton. You can see them really starting to take shape late in that second half. A little slow starts from